you think our vengeance was done, Savior? Oh no, it has only begun.
Greetings. Freedom.
Hello.
Mana. Much clatter.
Not all slaves believe Dutula's lies. Some I know have managed to steal a ship and are soon to set sail for Namakanui. Hopefully, with these treasures on board, Valakor will bless their voyage and breathe deeply into their sails. No, I'm not going with them. I helped bring this curse down upon Oriarth, so I'll help save what little there is left to save. Here, take something, in thanks for your part in preserving the Karui Way. Remember, we do this for freedom.
The High Priest is dead, yet the object of his devotion remains. There's no doubt you did all right bringing that man-turned-monster to heel, but you weren't able to stop him fishing his master out of a river of blood. Damn. Sorry. I never could get the hang of boosting morale. Didn't seem right to polish the edges off harsh facts. Probably why I never made captain. Still, I've been poking around here for a bit and have turned up Utula's stash. Quite the magpie he was. So here, help yourself. When it comes to hunting a god, I suppose every little bit helps. Don't ever give up.
Freedom comes to those. For freedom. Freedom comes to those who fight. For freedom.
Thank you. An empire is nothing more than a standard pitched to the naked earth. The time has come for you to raise the standard upon the peak of false faith, the apex of Chittas Cathedral. Drive it deep into that sacred stone. Mark the death of a faithless empire and slay the slavering kingdom that seeks to consume it.
Yes? For freedom.
Exile. The blight is trying to spread.
Thank you.
There is no shame in falling to a god. Shame lies only in refusing to rise again. You shall soar. That much I'm permitted to foresee. You shall ascend to the peak of your loftiest mistake, and from there you shall pluck a single surviving hope from the jaws of mortal despair. A ship sails for Lion Eye's Watch, not far from here. Be on it.
I'm Captain Lily Roth, and we sail for Rayclast. Better to live in exile than die on this psychotic bonfire of an island. You want to make it out of here, you'd better get on board. But make it quick, because I ain't got time for tears and regrets. Remember, this ain't no charity run. You owe me. Cast off!
All right, we're safe for the time being. Now let me introduce myself properly. Lily Roth. Yep, I'm one of those Roths. Some call me smuggler, others pirate. Yet I prefer the sound of nautical entrepreneur. Came up with that one myself. So you come see Lily if you need something, or even if you just fancy a good chat with a lovely lady. Don't think I'd be forgetting that favor you owes me. In fact, now I think of it, there's certainly a way you can be repaying this most considerable debt. You see, those blasted cultists have been plundering the refugee ships trying to escape Aureoth. And if not for my incomparable skill as a sea captain, we'd have met the same fate. But now the drowned dead are washing ashore, and they ain't staying dead. There's been a whole lot of blood, sweat and tears getting these few lucky survivors here in one piece. What sort of captain would I be if I let them get ripped apart by walking corpses? Wipe the Twilight Strand clean of those filthy undead bastards and they'll call us even. Might even throw in a little something extra if you can pull it off.
Despite your best efforts, Beastslayer, a splinter of hope remains. The very seed that brought my beast into existence. The Dark Ember. Never again shall it birth a life so magnificent as the beast. Yet a residue of that power still lingers. Enough to give us a fighting chance against the ravenous Kitava. How do we obtain this Dark Ember? Three hearts were silenced. Three hearts must sing again, one last time. In that final flickering of life, our savior's seed shall be born. All I need are three fine souls with which to stoke the flames. Chevron of Umbra, Inquisitor Maligaro, Doldre, the Dark Tongue. Three spirits of near unfathomable resilience and vigor, freed with the beast's final exhalation. So let us begin the harvest. Chevron has come home to Axiom. We shall give her the warm welcome she sincerely deserves. Goodbye.
Now there's a pair of eyes I could never forget. If the tales are true, those peepers of yours have seen all the wonders of Rayclast by now, and a few things they likely wish they hadn't. Oh, and no need for us to speak of Aureoth. My ears are brimful with the sorrows these wretched companions of yours have been spilling. Now, I'm sure you've noticed that Lion Ice Watch has seen better days. Our once bubbling township has, alas, become a brooding quagmire of gloom and despair. I blame the unrelenting weather. As you know, I am both a humanitarian and a strong believer in the soul-sustaining power of story. Back when I was still captain of the Merry Gull, many days at sea afforded me time to work on my thespian aspirations. I wrote a theatrical epic, a one-man show entitled Cedric and the Buxom Stranger. I sealed the manuscript inside a roll of oiled leather and stashed it in the hold for safekeeping. Perhaps you could salvage it for me from that tidal island upon which my poor ship came to rest. Who knows? Maybe we can bring some joy back to Lion Eye's Watch with a bit of live entertainment.
First we hear that Oriath has lost its bloody mind, and then you turn up. Doesn't take a scholar to work out how these two events might be connected. I don't know what's going on out there, and I probably wouldn't understand it if I saw it with my own two eyes. What I do know is this. The world we knew, it's gone. Now we have to do our damnedest to make sure we don't go with it. Nessa, I saw her one night, running out across the coast, headed in the direction of the mudflats. Called out to her, but she didn't even turn her head. Maybe she couldn't hear me. Maybe she didn't want to. I don't bloody know. I tried to run after her, but she'd vanished into the darkness before my feet had barely touched the sand. So I tracked her, all the way to the mudflats, and that's when her tracks, they just stopped. No sign of meeting someone or something. No sign of a struggle. It's like one moment she was running and the next, gone. Look, I've heard some things about what you've done. Things that beggar belief. Now you can do this, please. Find Nessa. Bring her back to us. Stay sharp out there.
Hello. Fate will find you.
That would just make life complicated. Thank you.
trying to spread!
Still working on it.
God's warmth. Too much clutter.
Still working on it, Poemy.
Submerged passage. It's underwater again, and there's no sign of those shells you used to drain it. Fortunately, there's another way to reach Axiom Prison and beyond. A path I scouted out myself, through what was once the fetid pool, and then along the ridge above it. Problem is, whatever's brought those Karui revenants to life has also sealed the pool entranceway with a bloody great totem. Stay sharp out there.
wretched sight. So many drowned Oriathans cast into undeath. You freed them from their torment, and I'm sure they'd be grateful. Here, that little something extra I were talking about. Though the sea takes away, it gives back in greater measure. While you be skulking about, I've managed to do a bit of hunting on my own. Got a hole full of baubles and trinkets here, which I managed to, procure. Take a look. You might find something particularly naughty to help you on your life's voyage.
Let me tell you.
Two Much clutter.
Welcome.
Marvelous! Oh, yes, yes, it's all here. Act one, scene one.
Along the shoreline, the beach grass sways. A blazing sun sinks neath sparkling bays. Oh, strange be the night when the drowned dead rise and a pale moon ascends upon cold skies. The stranger still is lost to me. Those silken pillows upon which I lay at sea.
Moody. Atmospheric. Not as funny as I remember. But I'm sure it gets better in Act Two. Regardless, you have my thanks. Please, take something for your efforts. And next time you're in town, do come and see the show. I'll leave your name at the door. If I can salvage a door from somewhere, that is.
You've seen Nessa. Talk to her. Well, that's more than I dared hope for, truth be told. This change she's going through, this curse the so-called Brine King has put on her, it can be broken. I know it. You've got to keep going. Follow her trail before it gets any colder. Make your way along the coast, the ship graveyard, even Mervale's cave if you must. By my reckoning, this king's not the sort to venture far from his briny bed.
That Karui relic you're carrying looks bloody familiar. Yeah, I've seen its twin stuck in that totem guarding Tukahama's doorstep. If I were you, and in this case, I'm glad I'm not, I'd see about putting that eye back where it belongs. It might do nothing at all, but it's at least worth a shot, I reckon.
Farewell.
Oh, I was never there.
teach you the laws of war.
The soil wants for your blood no more. I am Sin, thief of virtue, and it is mine to take what I will from the defeated, to make a gift of it to the victorious. Alas, your mortal frame cannot withstand the unfettered fire of deism. It would turn your blood to mist and scorch your precious flesh black. So choose modestly, and choose wisely, for there is much more at stake here than your little hopes and dreams.
Killed the Kaurui war god. Can you kill a god? Look, I can't even begin to understand what you've just done. Bestel will be able to put our gratitude into words more fitting of a legend. Me, I'll work with what I know. A solid reward for a damn fine deed. Stay sharp out there.
another good find. Greetings. See you later.
much clutter.
Thank you.
much clutter.
Greetings. Ta-da.
Clutter.
Hello. Stay in the light, Exile. Stay in the light, Exile.
this tower can really do.
Clumsy me. Much clutter.
And so it begins. My ethereal veins now run with dark ambition. Let's turn that trickle into a torrent. Let's harvest ourselves a Grand Inquisitor. Just as Chevron's spirit chose to return to comfortable climes, Maligara's essence once again dwells in his very own chamber of sins. Though I hasten to add that Maligara's sins are not my sins. I prefer transgressions of a more natural order than does he. I'd carry you to Freesia if I could, yet I expended too much of myself when I snatched you from the jaws of Kitava. You will need to find your own path, as will I. Make the journey, and please survive it. We too have much work left to do.
Who'd have thought those bleating bastards would go and find religion, eh? Now there's nothing quite so sure to spoil a man's appetite than an ecclesiastical debate come supper time. Yet this goatman god, this Aberarth, seems fair determined to mix his morsels with his spiritual enlightenments. To put no finer point on it, when the goatman find him a soft pink human or two as divine sacrifice, he eats them, meat, soul and all. Well, that's what the legends say.
Good work clearing another path through Axiom Prison. I'm starting to think those stories I've heard about you might be true. With the road to the Frisian Forest clear again, I trekked through to the forests beyond to see if the strangeness we're seeing on the coast is also happening inland. What I saw nearly froze my heart solid. The animals there, poor wretches, overtaken by some sort of parasite. As close as I can reckon, they're like termites, burrowing into flesh and mind instead of wood. If I'm right, there'll be a nest somewhere, and a queen. If you can find it, destroy it. Those parasites aren't something we want to see around here anytime soon. Farewell.